Poopsies. Welcome back to your ASMR session. It's me, Tony Bomboni. Today, I want to tell you about headache relief. And what works for me on easing headaches. And I've done a video before on this subject matter, and I'll link the link in the description box below for you to check it out. But that video was of me giving the headache advice and massage on myself. But this time I'm gonna give it on you instead, using just some simple microphone rubbing hand sounds, just to kind of portray the rubbing on you and the demonstration, so to speak. So I used to get a lot of headaches, and following my own advice, including others, has helped relieve that. What kind of motivated me in doing this video was when I had a really harsh migraine one day, and it affected the whole left side of my brain and head. I felt really numb in that area. I almost thought it was a stroke. Deal with the pain a whole day. It lasted a good 10 hours, this migraine attack, and the entire left side of my head and brain just went like almost completely numb, and I kept feeling pain on the left side of my brain, and it was unbearable. I had to take something to relieve the pain a little, because the last time I had something aromatherapy, essential oils, which I mentioned in the last video. You can get a mint oil and rub it on your temples, forehead to soothe the pain, maybe even have someone massage it in your scalp. That helps those lucky few of you who have partners or someone who can do that for you. You're very fortunate, just know that. Some of us have to do it ourselves. Do have recurring headaches like every week, it is definitely a problem, especially maybe in your diet and your continued lifestyle. I used to have weekly headaches, but that was when I was in school dealing with a lot of stress and pressure, and I was always indoors on the computer all day and stuff, so I wasn't even eating the best healthy food, to be honest, so yeah. And a part of it is also growing up, your brain's still growing, developing, and so you might feel pain from time to time. feel like, don't force water in your system. It's just gonna come right back out your kidneys and out the urethra. Don't force it, only when you feel thirsty enough, okay? And that's the amazing thing about the human body, is that we just need the right amount and balance of water, salt, sugars, okay? So if you intake too much water, you can maybe flush out all your salts and sugars, or vice versa, salt, and then you flush out all the water. So another amazing thing is, if you don't go but like a few hours without water, you're already in risk of losing some functioning motor capability in your brain, or, you know, having feelings of thirst and etc. Since we can only go 3 days without water, you can imagine a few hours is pretty disastrous. Alright, so you do want to drink water, at least one glass every few hours, minimum. So if you divide 8 glasses a day in 24 hours, that is equivalent to 3 hours. So yeah, have at least a sip or two every 3 hours. You do need it, and your body will tell you when you need more, when you're thirsty, okay? You'll just feel thirsty. Coffees, smoking, drinking, they make you thirsty, okay? I've done all of those things before. Soda, they make you thirsty. Tea makes you thirsty. Even lemonade, fruit juices, they make you thirsty. Eating chocolate, eating salty foods. What do you think all of that does? That's gonna trigger a headache, especially if you have all of those things in one day. No wonder you have a migraine. Not always, not always. Sometimes it's just a matter of how you're developed over time and your sensitivity to things. But you do want to be aware of diet first and foremost. That's the point I'm trying to get across to you. So taking deep breaths helps during the day, like I'm doing now. In through the nose and out through the mouth. That's the best advice I can give you for that. Meditation, it's not for everyone. Not everyone has the patience to sit. I used to have the patience to sit and meditate. Nowadays, I'm just too determined, focused on certain things. So, like just the fact that I have to sit down for 5 minutes, I want to lose my marbles, unless it's for like watching a YouTube video or something, you know. I also just have the patience to sit down and like lay down an hour at a time if I ever take face, but when I get even the slightest headache right here in the center of my forehead, that's a reminder I need water. So I guess the point I'm trying to get across to you today is that you do want to drink water. Don't be a camel like me and hold it in your hump and wait a few days. Because a lot of people also get these like little whiteheads, these forehead bumps from not drinking.
Just the natural healer and cure of disease and everything when you have.
person.